هيو الحلو هيو الله كريم.
هاي I'm Michelle Ramadan from Jerusalem.
My name is Donna Maria Mattas. I live in Gaza.
Hi, I'm Alaa Khayo from Jerusalem.
Hi, Anzam, how are you?
Yeah, hi, Ashira, how are you?
Camera, for you get all different angles from every position.
Perfect.
Which is, perfect. Yeah, hopefully it will be good. Hello. Yani, we have like these footage which we're gonna begin with, which is not this one because I think she's sleeping. Yeah, she's pretty. Well. You have actually I have a few pictures of people sleeping, which will not.
That's not good.
No, we won't put them. But I'll start with the general shots of the people starting in the conference. I think one of the highlights is Atalla Hanna's
Yes, his speech was very emotional, perfect, addressing all the Palestine network founders.
Yeah,
it was great.
Basically how it started. Do you want me to make it bigger than the screen?
No, it's fine.
I'll just make it a little bigger than you can see. So Hanna, is everyone gone from the conference?
Not all of them. We still have a couple of people from Chile and Argentina still staying in with their families, of course, from Mijala and Bethlehem.
That's nice. And I always had a surprise. Like, I met a few people that have never been here before, and they're actually going to meet family for the first time.
Yes. I mean, the whole conference, the whole Palestine Network Founding Conference, was a great success, not only for the founders, but also for us as staff working with Palestine Network. I mean,
you almost died.
Oh yeah, working until like 5 a.m. in the morning. Yeah, but the whole idea is great. I mean, having around 100 founders coming from all over the world, every continent, almost every country in the world, representing either Palestinians or friends of Palestine. Those people are coming here to join the idea of Palestine Network and working together to build the democratic state of Palestine.
So what are they like? What did they come out with in the end? You know, I noticed there was a lot of talking about how to actually put the start like the
projects.
Hierarchy of the projects. But what did they actually come up with?
Well, there was a couple of meetings between all of them to come up with their final concept paper and come up with their final bylaws for the Palestine Network. And also there was
uneducated.
Let's go with that. Yes, the
project
or
future projects that will be implemented by Palestinians and friends of Palestine.
Inside Palestine,
for Palestinians in the 1948 land.
And also
yes. Okay. I mean, we're gonna start clubs in every city. We're trying every city and every country in the world. And the first club will be actually started in Jerusalem. Yes, exactly. And the head of it will be No, actually, Atalla Hanna will.
Oh, really?
Yes, he will be the head of our club in Jerusalem.
But yeah, I'll definitely think about joining the club. It sounds
definitely.
Cool
I mean, you can join. There's going to be two types of clubs: clubs that are general clubs and specialized clubs.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, based on the projects and the sessions, the specialized sessions that were held in the conference, there's one that is related to health, health sector, building the health sector in Palestine, education sector, lobbying and communication, economics, the youth, the No Palestine project, tourism projects. There's going to be a lot of projects to support Palestinians and the state of Palestine.
It's good that they actually, yani, I know, out of all of like the whole program, the conference, because I like to hear the, I liked meeting the people and seeing like the stories and everyone.
Yeah.
I met people who've never, like, you know, when you imagine when you're living here for years and you're just used to everything here, and then when people come from abroad and they're Palestinians, you expect them to be distant.
Exactly.
But I met a few of them who like automatically they saw the olive trees and they're
ريحه
زيت الزيتون والبرتقال, and I'm like, you know,
I know, it was, it
they
was
still feel it.
Yes.
Even though they're yani living in exile for something like I don't know how many years, their second, third generation had immigrants.
It was very emotional for us and for them. There was around 40 people who came to Palestine for the first time. They were either Palestinian refugees or Christians who left the country a long time ago. And this was the first time they come to Palestine.
Yeah.
It was so emotional
for
us and for them. It was great.
So Bahala, this the project that I'm working on, which is basically to put together a documentary. Where is
it's
it going to go on the website? Is it going to go for everyone?
Yes, it's for sure it's going to go on the our website, which is PalestineNetwork.com. And part of it will go as well into our online community. We're working on two, two tracks. The tracks of the clubs that I already mentioned, and the track of the Palestine Network online community, which is something similar to Facebook, but it's only for Palestinians and Friends of Palestine to implement their projects and have their own dialogues online.
Okay, but are you going to give it, it's also going to be given to press? So I just know what I'm working on.
Yeah, we don't mind, but this is going to be our own archive.
And I've been looking at the pictures, I found a lot of interesting stuff. You know, when you film it, you're not really looking at it. But once I put it, I've been looking at it for almost all day, and there's a lot of interesting things.
Palestinians represented from the 22 countries at this conference, welcome to your second home. Only a few months back, we came out with a concept. It was a concept paper, doesn't look like anything in what you see now in the documents that you got at the conference. And the idea was basic, a network for Palestinians in order to engage them in liberating Palestine and building the Palestinian state, in order for all of us to rally behind our national project, the project of the Palestine Liberation Organization, the project of our people that states that we are going to have a democratic state that has certain criteria. This criteria was declared by our martyr, President Yasser Arafat, in 1988, in his Declaration of Independence, when he said that our state is going to be democratic. He said it is going to enjoy independence of judiciary, equality, it is going to be based on human rights, and it is going to enjoy freedoms of press and speech. And all of this criteria is exactly what the Palestinian people want, and what we want to do is to build it ourselves. You said that this network is not only going to have clubs all over the world, but it's also going to have clubs here in Palestine, in the West Bank, in Gaza, in 1948, and also in the refugee camps, in the diaspora and in the land and in the homeland.
It was a very emotional speech. Yeah, it was really good.
Which one?
Back.
Lala, listen, you didn't see the one we're keeping. I'm keeping it as a surprise, but hello, you see
it. هنالك نكبة جديدة في مدينة القدس، أحياء عربية مهددة بأن يقتلع أهلها منها، أحياء عربية مهددة بأن تتهود وتتأسرل، أحياء عربية يعيش أهلها فيها وكأنهم غرباء، في حين أنهم أصحاب الأرض وأصحاب المقدسات وأصحاب المدينة. الفلسطيني في القدس يعامل كالغريب، في حين أن الغريب هو الذي أتى واحتل واستعمر واستولى على هذه الأرض زورا وبهتانا. هذا هو الغريب الذي يجب أن ينقلع عنا، وليس الفلسطيني الذي هو ابن هذه الأرض ويجب أن يبقى في هذه الأرض. وبما أنكم تجتمعون من أجل فلسطين، تذكروا أن القدس هي قلب فلسطين، ويجب أن تكون مدينة القدس حاضرة في مشاريعكم، في نشاطاتكم، في فعالياتكم. القدس تناشدكم، القدس بحاجة إليكم، فقفوا إلى جانبها وهي تتعرض لهذه العنصرية ولهذه السياسة المرفوضة من قبلنا جملة وتفصيلا.
Oh my God, that's me crying. Yeah. I didn't know he was filming.
No, we were filming the whole thing. Everyone was crying. There wasn't anyone in this conference who wasn't crying on the speech.
Yeah, I didn't stop crying throughout the whole speech.
I think it's one of the best speeches that were given throughout the whole conference.
Yes, definitely. And being in the same hall with all those Palestinians coming from all over the world, from all over the continent, it was very emotional for us all gathered for the same cause and to build the democratic state of Palestine and, of course, the Palestine Network.
And even for me, like, I'm considered an outsider in the sense of a journalist, but still it was quite emotional because most of the time you're feeling so isolated and that you're fighting the occupation and you're living the situation on your own, and you feel that everyone outside doesn't really care.
Yeah.
But when you see that Palestinians outside are still with you, they still want to help,
but also friends of Palestine were attending.
Exactly. Yeah, it makes you feel like that at least you're not alone in one thing or another.
Yeah, of course.
طيب. So now,
show me the other sessions.
Before I show you the sessions, I've just realized how rude I am. Do you want something to drink?
Water would be fine.
طيب هلا I'm gonna check, but it's almost empty, this place.
Can I stay around with it?
If you can check the pictures if you want. So I'm telling you, someone messes up this computer because it's before me. Just link everything together. Okay. So now I think. Like from the old
Yes, they're not exactly. These two guys, they used to be with Ashiqin, they're still with Ashiqin, but they're not the old generation, they're the new generation. Do you know that Ashiqin used to be the PLO official musical band in the old days?
I just know that they're the oldest Palestinian band.
There was a split between them anyways, but we're getting them on board. We're having them as our own Palestine network. Music band, Al-Ashiqin, yes. And both of them, Isa and Muhammad, this is the first time for them in the country. Muhammad is still in town, Isa left.
Muhammad is the main singer. Wow, that's very good that you actually had that they're actually going to be for a Palestine network, that's amazing.
Yeah, and he's still in town, I mean.
So I would really like to meet him. What is he like? How long is he staying?
He's still staying. He's going to be in the country for a week. I think tomorrow he'll be visiting Yasser Arafat Museum in You mean Ramazan? Yeah.
Walla. So what is it? Is he gonna like do something, sing, or just heka? Just
no, he's just gonna be visiting. You mean, I think.
Walla. So can I come? Do you think?
Yeah, I'm sure I can. Would I'll you? Arrange something between you
it
and him.
It would be great if I can get
let
to
me, let me call him.
Because I love this one of his songs. Allah,
let,
I'll put it for
me,
you. I love
let
it.
Me call him and see what is
if
he
can,
doing.
Yeah, that
tomorrow.
Would be great. That would be great.
هاي محمد، كيفك؟ شو أخبارك؟ كيف بيت لحم؟ مبسوط في بيت لحم؟ طيب، كتير منيح، كتير منيح. أنت حسب ما أنا بعرف، أنت بكرة حتكون برمضان رح تيجي تزور ضريح الشهيد ياسر عرفات، صحيح؟ تمام، تمام، تمام. في صديقة لإلي أشيرة عم تشتغل على إذا الدوكيومنتري؟
يعني زي ريالتي
زي هيك تلفزيون واقعي وهيك أشياء للتلفزيون، فبتحب كثير تقعد معك وتحكي معك عن العاشقين وعن زيارة تاعتك للبلد، بما انك انت اول واحد، انت يعني وانت وعيسى اول اثنين من فرقة العاشقين عم بيدخلوا على فلسطين. ما عندك مشكلة، خلص تمام. شكرا كثير لك محمد. اوكي بشوفك، انا بشوفك بكره الصبح. هلا، باي 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 باي.
ثانك يو حياتي، ذيس از جريت، ذيس از غانا بي فيري فيري نايس.
يا
So tomorrow we're gonna go visit the Palestinian former Palestinian president's mausoleum, and we're gonna be with Firqat al-Ashiqin as well. We're gonna be with one of them, and it's just gonna be great.
Yes,
I'm very excited. I really want to meet him.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think everybody knows the song. Do you know it?
طبعاً
من
سجن عكا، في حدا بيعرفه؟
هلا، I have it filled. والله. Do you think he would be able to sing it to us there?
Yeah, I mean, he wouldn't mind. He was singing for us every single night at the hotel in Beit Lahem.
السنة اللي فايز نص السنة اللي فاتت وهي نص السنة هذه، وإحنا في المطر وعشتنا حالتنا على الله. عندي طلع 10 تنفار من الكلاب، مش عارفين ننام من الفيران، مش عارفين ننام العقارب والصراصير ودينا، والله ما إحنا عارفين ننام. وأنا ما أنتوا شايفين اتغرقنا في الصيف، لا إحنا قادرين نقعد في الخيم، وفي الشتاء ما إحنا عارفين نقعد في الخيم، وفي الشتاء في المطر. بدنا الشعب يحن علينا، بدنا المسلمين يحنوا علينا، وشوفوا وضعنا، شوفوا حالنا اللي احنا قاعدين فيه.
أمي بقت بالبيت تبعنا من الجمعة للجمعة، تحصل ما بقت تشوف لما تنطر الدنيا. كل إخواتي مية، إحنا مية، كيف كل شوي غيار؟ والله ولا غيار عندهم، كل شوي بغير بوسخ كل وقاطع الكهرباء، ولا بتجي علينا ولا حاجة. بتجي دقيقة بتقطع، بتجي ساعة بتقطع، وإحنا ضلنا هذا مات كسروا لنا اليوم اجتاحونا قصفوها لنا اختي بقى لها سرير انا بقى لي تخت كيف الوقت تفرج بننام مع بعض يعني الفرش ما كفش تبعنا الخيام مليانة مية خيمتنا مليانة مية يعني هذه عيشة مش اسمها مش عيشة احنا مفروض الوقت بالبيت تبعنا
طب ايش تتمنى انت يكون عندك هلا
بتمنى نكون ببيتنا يصلحونا بيتنا يا
بسم الله عليكم بسم الله
ايش اسمك
حنين
حنين ولا
بنت
ما شاء الله
here is a new life a new situation this baby called Hanin Abu Layla she born after the war and she have a lot of bad things She don't know what the life is hide for her. Her mom needs three surgeries. She did one, she did two, and she need money to do this, the third. She's very sad. She wants money. She's not happy in this situation. This situation is very bad for her.